Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to make a resume in 5 minutes in Microsoft Word. And no, we're not going to use a template. We are going to create it from scratch. So first, I'm going to go down here in my toolbar and launch Microsoft Word. And then I'm going to go to a blank document. Usually, there's four elements to a resume. You have your contact information, your experience, your skills, and your education. So let's think about how we are going to lay those out on this page. So if I click here and center it, I can put my name, I can put my phone number, I can put my email, and I can put my address. And then I'm going to hit the left align again. And now I'm going to put in the three things that we talked about: experience, skills, and education. So these represent different sections of our resume. So under my experience, I'm going to go up to insert, and I'm going to insert a 2x1 table. Because what I want to do on one side of my table is I want to have the dates that I worked from date to date. And over here, I want to have my job title, my company, and maybe the city and state of the company. So after I hit enter, I would like to go up here and add a bulleted list of things I did for this company. So I'm going to click the bullets tab, and I'm going to talk about my experience here. Usually, it's a good idea to look at the job description and see what they're looking for. So add some experience in here of something you've maybe done. Don't make up things like Joey on Friends, that he can drink a gallon of milk in 1 minute. But maybe you want to come here and say, oh, I've done that in this job. Here's how I've done it. So you want to talk about your accomplishments. And you also want to talk about maybe any awards that you received at work or anything like that. So as soon as I hit enter, you can see that I have another bullet point here. And I can just elaborate on my accomplishments here. So maybe I want to make the job title bold, and maybe I want to italicize the name of the company. So if that's the format that I would like to go with for every entry in my resume, what I'm going to do here is at the end of my table, I'm going to hit tab so that I can get a new row. And then I'm going to highlight what's in that row and hit Control C for copy, click in the new row and hit Control V, and then I'm going to hit tab again, and I'm going to hit Control V again. Now you can see I can elaborate on the experience that I had from each one of these past jobs. Same thing with my skills. If I go in here, I can insert another table. Maybe this time I want to have a 4x1 table so I can elaborate on the different skills that I've picked up. So again, if I go back to home and I create a bulleted list, I can write skill 1, skill 2, skill 3, etc. And make sure you're also gleaning from the job posting to see what kind of skills you want to put here, and so on and so forth. I can put more in these columns over here. And so for education, you guessed it, after education, I can hit enter, go up to insert, and insert another 2x2 table. And here I would say year graduated. And then over here, I would say degree, name, comma, school, name, and then city and state. And if you would like to bold that degree name, I can go over to home and hit bold, or I can hit Control B on the keyboard. I can highlight my school name and hit Control I to italicize it. And if there are any awards you got, you could hit enter and put in some awards. I can also hit tab, and if I have any other kind of education, like certificates I received or other programs I have gone through, I could put those down here as well. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to get new weekly Microsoft Office tips. So as you can see, the resume looks pretty plain right now. I'm going to highlight this table and go up to borders and select no border. Same with my skills. I'm going to highlight that table and do the same thing. And under education, I'm going to hit the borders that I just previously did. I can make my name bigger if I go to my font size, and maybe I would like a different font for that as well. You can change that. And you can reformat this to insert another table here if you'd like to split that information up at the top. Also, it's kind of nice when you have sections like this. You could put a bottom border and a top border if you would like to distinguish these from other parts of your resume. You can also highlight this table and hover your mouse over the center bar until you get the left and right arrow, and then hold down the left mouse button and drag to the left so that you have more room for your experience and less room for the dates. Same down here in education. I just highlighted that table, went to the center line, hold the left mouse button down, and just drag to line it up with your experience. So hopefully that's enough to get you started on your resume, and good luck getting that job.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our academy Online course today.